Happy day to all of you, my dear children. Greetings from Icon School of Excellence. I am Alekia, your teacher. I am here to teach you all mathematics for grade 3. I wish all of you are safe, doing good and ready to learn. Today, I am bringing you all an interesting topic. Before I begin, let me show you a small video.
I'll draw a line.
I'm bigger, so I'll start.
10
minus 2
equals 8.
Game on! Ready? Go!
Octo block, play! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, play! He's on the left. And now the right. On my head, now out of sight.
Woohoo!
Up high, down low, too slow.
Action!
Now, so it's my turn. 9
minus 2
equals 7.
Ready? Go!
Okay, children, what is the video about? Yes, right? Now you understood the topic which I am going to teach you. That is subtraction. So let us revise the concept subtraction today. Okay, this is a concept which you have already learned in your grade 2. But let me revise you once again. Okay. Okay. Subtraction. What do you mean by subtraction? Taking one number away from another. You have two numbers and you have to take away one number from another number, then we call that as subtraction. Okay, suppose I have 5 chocolates and you are taking 3 chocolates from me. That means you are taking away 3 chocolates from me. So then the action which we are doing is called as subtraction. The actual mathematical operation which we are doing is subtraction. So what is subtraction? Subtraction is taking away one number from another number. Okay. So these are the terms or the other names of subtraction. So whenever you see these terms like subtract, decrease, difference, deduct, take away or minus, that means that you will be subtracting the given number. Clear, children? So these are the other terms or other mathematical terms which you can see in place of subtraction. Okay. In subtraction, a subtrahend is subtracted from a minuend to find the difference. So I will tell you what is this about. So these are the terms used in So these are the keywords or the terms used in subtraction. What are the keywords? See, 9 minus 3 equals to 6. This is a subtraction which I am doing here. So from 9, I am taking away 3 and you are getting 6, right? You are left over with 6. So what is 9 here? 9 is called as minuend. The bigger number from which we are subtracting is called minuend. And the smaller number which we are subtracting from the bigger number is called as subtrahend. And the answer which we are going to get after subtracting two digits, we call it as a difference. Okay, children, these are the important terms which you have to remember in subtraction. So you are subtracting two numbers. Remember, always you can subtract a small number from a bigger number. You cannot take away the smaller number from a bigger number. Suppose I have 3 chocolates, and if you are asking me for 5 chocolates, would I be able to give you? No, right? So always I should have more number of chocolates so that I can give you the 3 number of chocolates or the chocolates which you asked, right? So if we have to subtract two numbers, the minuend should be the bigger number and subtrahend should be the smaller number. Okay, so only then we can subtract two numbers. Okay, what is this first term? The number from which we are subtracting is called as minuend. The digit which is subtracted, which is being subtracted from minuend is called as subtrahend. And the answer which we are going to get after subtraction, we call it as difference. Okay, so these three are the key terms, keywords which you have to remember in your subtraction. In subtraction, a subtrahend is subtracted from minuend to find difference. Right? After subtracting two numbers, the answer which you are going to get is called difference. The following equation. So this is a subtraction statement here. 9 is a minuend and 3 is a subtrahend and 6 is the difference. See, as I told you, the bigger number is minuend and 3 is subtrahend and then 6 is called difference. Right? This is all about subtraction. What do you mean by subtraction? Subtraction is taking away one number from another number. Then we are subtracting two numbers. So these are the terms which are used in place of subtraction. Whenever you see difference, deduct, take away, minus, these terms, it means that you are going to subtract two numbers. Next. Two-digit subtraction with no regrouping. What do you mean by regrouping, children? Already we have learned about this regrouping in addition. But regrouping in addition is different from regrouping in subtraction. Here in regrouping, we are taking borrow from tens place. That we will see. Okay. But as of now, let us see two-digit subtraction without regrouping or with no regrouping. Okay. See, I have a two-digit number here, 45, and then I'm going to subtract 21 from 45. So we all know that 45 is a bigger number, right? And 21 is a smaller number. So we can subtract 21 from 45. So let us start in subtraction as well. We are going to start subtraction from ones place only. So what is ones place? This is ones place and this is tens place, isn't it? So start subtracting numbers from ones column. So 5 minus 1. See here, I am asking you to take away. So take 5 fingers and take away 1 finger. So 5 minus 1 means take away 1 finger. That gives you 4. See here are the number blocks through which the number 45 is represented. 45, how do you form 45? 4 tens blocks makes 40 and 5 ones blocks make 5, right? So this is how I represent 45 in the form of number blocks. So now out of 5, I am taking away how many? 1, right? So see, I have removed 1. And how many ones are left over now? 4 ones. See now, 4 ones. 4 ones are left over, right? And then coming to tens place. I am done with my ones place, so I am moving to tens place. 4 minus 2. 4 tens. out of 4 tens, I am taking away how many tens? 2 tens. I am taking away 2 tens. Then how many tens are left over here? 2 tens, right? So 4 tens minus 2 tens gives you 2 tens or 20, right? So 20, 2 tens makes 20 and 4 ones makes 4. So 2 tens plus 4 ones or 20 plus 4 gives you 24. So this is how we can represent subtraction in the form of blocks also. This is for your understanding, okay? So 45 is a 2-digit number and 21 is a 2-digit number. So I always start subtracting with ones place. So 5 is bigger than 1? Yes. So I can continue subtracting these 2 digits. Now, I have 5 ones out of which I am going to take away 1, right? So how many ones do I have now? 4 ones, right? Next, coming to tens column, I have 4 tens out of which I am taking away 2 tens, right? See, I am taking away 2 tens. So how many tens do I have now? 2 tens. 2 tens or 20 and 4 ones or 4, that gives you 24. Okay. This is how you subtract 2-digit numbers. That doing without regrouping. If you are not regrouping, then this is how you will be doing. So here is one more example. Start here. See, you will be always starting with ones place, right? In subtraction also, you always start with ones place. So 8 minus 2. Out of 8, you will be taking away 2. So take 8 fingers and take away 2 fingers. So 8 minus 2 gives you how much? 6, right? Good. Now, I am done with my ones column. So now I am moving to my tens column. 6 minus 4. My minuend is greater than subtrahend. So I can subtract these two numbers. So 6, keep in mind or take on fingers and take away 4. So 6 minus 4 gives you 2. Good. So this is how you will be subtracting 2-digit numbers. So always start subtracting from ones place. First rule is that. And second rule is that when you are subtracting, see that minuend should be greater than subtrahend. Only then you can subtract the numbers. Otherwise, you cannot do the subtraction. Okay, children? Next. What is regrouping? So, what is regrouping in subtraction? Regrouping or borrowing is a word which we use to take 10 from one number to give to another number. So, take 10 from one number and give to another number. This is what regrouping in subtraction means, right? We do this when we do not have enough to subtract two numbers. I'll tell you what it is, okay? So how do you know when to regroup? You know, you may be having a doubt that how would I know that now this is a sum with regrouping or this is a sum without regrouping? Here is the answer for that. You know it's time to regroup when the number you are subtracting is larger than the number which you are subtracting from. This means when your minuend is smaller than your subtrahend, the number which you are subtracting is greater than the number which you are subtracting from. Then you have to go for subtraction with regrouping. Okay, children? So let us see this with one example here. So here are some examples. So 25 is a 2-digit number and then 18 is a 2-digit number here. Okay. So I have to subtract 25 from 18. So let me start my subtraction with ones place. So what is the digit in ones place here? 5, and then digit in ones place here is 8. So if you see, the second rule which I told was the minuend should be greater than subtrahend. But in this case, minuend is smaller than subtrahend, isn't it, children? Yes, so I cannot subtract this. If I have 5 chocolates and if you ask me to give 8 chocolates, would I be able to give you? No, right? Yes, the same way, 5 is a minuend and 8 is a subtrahend, where I cannot take away 8 from 5. So what I do is, I go to my next house, that is 10's house. I go to 10's house and ask for 110. Ask for 110 as a borrow. Okay. As a borrow, I am going to 10th house and then getting 1/10 here. See now, initially how many ones I have here? 5 ones I had, but I cannot take away 8 from 5. So what I did is, I went to my next house, that is 10th house, and I borrowed 1/10 here. Okay, see, 5 cannot take away from 8. So we must borrow from 2. So here, from 2/10, I am borrowing 1/10. See, here I have 2/10, out of which I am going to borrow 1/10 to 1's house. Okay. So now all together, how many I have? 10 and then 5 together makes 15, isn't it? Yes, 15. Now, I can take away 8 from 15, right? If I have 15 chocolates and if you are asking for 8, I can give you, right? It is possible for me to give. So now I can subtract these two numbers. So keep 15 in mind and then start counting backwards. Okay? Start counting backwards. 15 in mind, then start counting backwards. 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8. Right? So what is the 15 minus 8? How many you will get? It is 7. Right? Yes. Next. So now you have already taken one ten is borrowed by one's house. So how many tens do we have now? We have only 1/10 here. So 1 minus 1 gives you 0. So similarly, there is one more example. See, 11, right? So this is 51 minus 49, right? So here my minuend is 1 and my subtrahend is 9. Can you take away 9 from 1? No, it is not possible because it should be more on top than digit on floor, right? So what I do is I go to my 10th house because in my 10th house I have 5 tens. From that 5 tens, I borrow 1/10 here to my 1's house. Okay? So 1 and then I am taking 1/10 from 10th house to 1's house. So 10 plus 1 gives you how much? 11, right? Good. So 11. So from 11 you will be taking away 9. Is it possible? Yes, because 11 is greater than 9. I can take away 9 from 11. So what you do is you keep 11 in mind and then start counting backwards. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2. So 11 minus 9 gives you how much? 2. Good. Now how much is it is in tens place? How many tens do I have in tens place? Now after giving 1/10 to ones place, I have 4 tens here. So 4 minus 4 gives you 0. So this is how you will be doing two digit subtraction with borrow or with regrouping. Okay, children, let us see some more examples here. Yes, see, 72 minus 56. Okay, so 2, what is the digit in ones place? This is 2 and here I have 6. My minuend is 2 and my subtrahend is 6. My minuend is greater than, smaller than subtrahend, right? Here I cannot take away 6 from 2. Yes, right? So then what I have to do? I should go to my next house, that is 10th house, and ask for 1/10, right? I'll be asking to give me 1/10 here. Okay, so now what happens? More on floor, go to the neighbor. So if you see a digit which is more on floor, this is more on top and this is floor. So if you have a smaller number on top than the number on floor. So if you see that, then go to borrow. Borrow, how many you will be borrowing? You will be borrowing 1/10, right? So 7 tens becomes 6 tens here because 1/10 you will be carrying it to 1's place. So here I already have 2 ones and if I borrow 1/10 from here, then it will become 12, right? I already had 2 ones and 1/10. 1/10 plus 2 ones gives you how much, children? 12, right? Yes. Now I have 12 here and 6 here. Now more on top or more on bottom? More on top, right? So I can carry on my subtraction. Now 12 minus 6. Take 12 in mind and then count backwards 6 numbers. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7 and then 6, right? Yes. So 12 minus 6 gives you 6. And then as I have given 1 10 to my 1's house, I have now only 6 tens. Okay, 6 minus 5. 6 minus 5 gives you 1. 6 fingers minus 5 fingers gives you 1 finger. So 16 is the difference which you get after subtracting 2 numbers, that is 72 and 56. Similarly, we have another problem here. 72 minus 34. So here also if you see, I have more on bottom. So I have 2 on top which is less than 4 on bottom, right? So what I do is I go to my next house, that is 10's house, and I borrow 1 10 from 10's house. So now 1 10 plus 2 1 becomes how much? 12, right? And this 7 tens now becomes 6 tens because I gave 1 10 to my 1's place, right? So now 12 minus 4. 12 keep in mind and then count backwards 4 numbers. 11, 10, 9 and then 8, right? So 8, 12 minus 4 gives you 8. And then here I have 6 ones now as I gave 1 10 to my 1's house. So 6 minus 3 gives you 3, yes. So 72 minus 34 gives you 38, which is the difference after subtracting these two numbers. Hope you understood this subtraction concept, children. Okay, let us do a small exercise on this, okay? So I have two numbers, 18 and then 12. You will be subtracting 18 and then 12. Okay, what is the first rule? You always start subtracting from 1's place. That is first rule. What is the second rule? You check if it more on top or more on bottom. If it is more on top, then you need not go for regrouping or borrowing. Okay, you can directly subtract. 8 minus 2, more on top, right? So I can directly go for subtraction. 8 fingers, out of which you will be taking out 2 fingers, then 6. Good. Now, 1 minus 1 gives you 0. Next, 76 minus 42. So, more on top or more on bottom? More on top. So, I need not go for regrouping. So, 6 in mind, count backwards 2 numbers. 6, 5 and then 4. So, 6 minus 2 gives you 4. Then, 7. Moving to 10's column, 7 minus 4. 7 fingers, out of which 4 fingers you are going to take away. So the answer which you get is 3. Good. Now see this problem. First start with 1's column and next check more on top or more on bottom. See here you have more bigger number in the bottom or in the subtrahend place when compared to a digit in minus, right? So what we have to do now is we have to go to 10's column and then borrow 1 10 to 1's place. So now this 5 becomes 4 because this is if this 5 is going to give 1 10 to this 3 or 1's house. So this 5 tens becomes 4 tens and this 3 tens, 3 ones which I have here after borrowing 1 10 from here becomes 13. Good. Because 1 10 plus 3 ones gives you 13. Yes. Similarly, now I can subtract these two numbers because I have 13 on top and I have 9 on bottom, which is possible for me to subtract two numbers. So 13 minus 9 gives you 13, keep in mind, and then count backward 9 numbers. 9. So 12, 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5 and then 4. Good. Now here I have 4 ones because I gave 1 10 to 4 tens. Here I gave 1 10 to 1's place, right? So I am left over with only 4 tens now. 4 minus 1 gives you 3. Good. So here the same way. Here I have 0 and here I have 5. Can I take away 5 from 0? No. So I go to my tens column and then I borrow 1 10 to 1's column. So now this 4 becomes 3 because 1 10 I am going to give it to 1's column. And this 0 will become 10 because I don't have any 1's here. Whatever I take from 10's column that remains here. So 10 minus 5 gives you 5 and 3 minus 3 gives you 0. Good. Now, so 35 minus 18. Just check the digit in 1's place here. This is 5 and this is 8. More on top or more on bottom? More on bottom. So I have to go for borrow, right? Yes. Now, this 3, from these 3 tens, I'm going to take or borrow 1 ten. So this 3 tens becomes 2 tens and this, after taking 1 ten, this 5 becomes 5 ones plus 1 ten gives you 15, right? So now 15 minus 8. 15 keep in mind and count backward 8 numbers. So 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9, 8 and then 7, right? Good. Now these 3 tens becomes 2 tens because I gave 1 ten to 1's column. So 2 minus 1 gives you 1. Very good. Now, so 2 minus 6. Can I take away 6 from 2? No, right? So what I do? I go to tens column and I borrow 1 ten to 1's column. So what does this 7 becomes? 7 becomes 6 because out of 7 tens, I am going to take away 1 ten. So only 6 tens are left over. And then this 2 becomes 12 because I borrowed 1 ten from tens column. So 10 plus 2 becomes 12. So 12 minus 6. 12 keep in mind and then count backwards 6 numbers. 11, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, right? So 12 minus 6 gives you 6. And then 6 minus 5. 6 minus 5 gives you 1 or 110, right? Yes. So children, I hope you all understood what I have taught you in this class. And I request you to revise the concepts which are in your grade 2 because, you know, whatever you are going to learn in grade 3 will be the continuation of grade 2 concepts only. So if you are thorough with your grade 2 concept, it will be easy for you to understand the concepts in grade 3. Okay, children. I look forward to see you in my next session and eager to bring you all interesting topics. Lots and lots of wishes to you for your health and safety from all of us at Icon School of Excellence. Happy learning. Thank you, students.